Thanks, Sarah.
Bye-bye.
Bye, bye, Peter. Thanks.
Then from Cable Hut, you can just to the top.
Okay, the summit.
To the summit. And after the summit, we can just come down to Stella Point. And then from the crater camp, we can come back to Stella Point and then down to Baraf camp.
Okay, so this is a stopping point. The porters are going to do some shopping. This is their last stop before we hit the mountain. So just getting the essentials that they need so they can spend 10 days up there with us.
So we are just seeing the lovely gentleman come from.
Feel pretty good right now.
Honestly,
nice mattresses.
Yeah, very nice. Way better than what I was about to buy at REI.
They're good. Those are bags. Nice. Sorted.
Okay, so what we're doing is we already set up camp. So we're climbing 700-800 feet higher than where we're sleeping at. So we can basically get more out of breath. So when we go down, our lungs will expand and then we can obviously sleep better tonight.
Also, I'm not a professional guide, but sometimes it feels like we're walking away from the mountain.
Yes. You have appetite?
Yes.
You're on diamond?
Yes.
Okay, so we had fajitas, handmade tortillas, handmade guacamole. It was like paka.
That's Kilimanjaro. That is Kenya. This is Tanzania. And that's Andy.
I'm bad.
And I'm tired.
You can go.
Okay.
Waiting for dinner.
So this is the kitchen that cooks all the 5-course meals that we're getting to enjoy. Pantry, head chef. Wow. Yeah.
Leeks potato.
Potato?
Leeks potato.
Leeks potato.
Yep.
Sure. Look at this fresh roasted peanuts.
And they're cutting fresh herbs over there.
Hello.
So peanuts instead of popcorn today, huh?
Good, good. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
So right now, Andy's not feeling very good. And Oreo says he has the
early stages of hypothermia, but we're breaking it.
I know.
In Jesus' name.
Hey, how are you?
And Wario's fixing him up.
That's the plan.
Just gonna get him fixed up so he can get back on the trail.
I don't feel cold anymore, but I don't feel better. I'm just feeling more nauseous.
You see me?
When I walked to get my shoes, I felt dizzy. Like a little nauseous. I don't feel like I have to throw up, but thinking about throwing up sounds good.
Well, you feel better?
I feel 1,000% better.
Really?
I threw up all my lunch and all that spark. I didn't get any on your jacket. I was like this. Yeah. I sat on a rock, tried to throw up, couldn't make myself throw up. So I turned around and I looked at the mountain and I instantly threw up.
No way.
Because the thought of like working out or like going higher right now just made me, I was like, whoa. And they came over and they said, this happens all the time, you're not going down, don't worry about it. So, bonus, they're going to serve me dinner in my tent tonight. So I'm going to go, I'm going to take the hot water and go lay down.
Yeah.
And he said he'll bring a tent, he'll bring food in there when it's ready.
Okay, so we're on day 6. We left a camp about 2 or 3 hours ago, and we're climbing from 13,300 up to 15,800, and we came from that direction. Right behind Michael is the actual mountain, and we're very, very close, so it's getting small every time. These are our guides right here. Oreo, Story, and our safety guy in the back.
Sam.
He's carrying the oxygen tent and the actual canister of oxygen. We're all doing good, feeling good, our breathing's getting good, our oxygen levels are great, and we're climbing up to the next point. Tomorrow we will summit.
Oh, that's better. I should have trained instead of eat wings, but those lemon pepper you can't beat.
This half oxygen business. We're at 15,500 right now, and we're going to climb an additional, basically 3,500 tomorrow, roughly. It's going to be about a 7-hour climb. By the time we get to the ridge, then we're going to be probably crawl or switch back in, left, right, until we get up to the summit. We're going to leave, we're going to get up at 4 o'clock, eat breakfast at 4:30, then we're going to be going, actually leaving at 5 a.m. It's going to be cold, tomorrow night we'll be sleeping in the crater, we can expect between minus 15, minus 20, and then we're going to head down after that to, Andrew, what's the name of that camp? Yeah, after we to crater camp, we're going to spend the night there. We go to
the Rafu camp for lunch.
Yeah.
And then Moika camp to sleep.
Right.
Hike out in the morning to our awaiting ride back to the hotel.
Yeah, take a hot shower. It's going to be probably the best shower we've ever had. We just saw a guy just now. He's not with our group, he's with another group. And here's the difference with Tusker Trail, is there's three of us, we got 24 porters, two trained guys, two medical guys, okay, and they've, you know, been excellent all the way up. This other group had 24 total, and there's 6 of them, and they did it in 6 days, and we just saw one of the guys getting carried down. When I spoke to another guy that looked really, real fit and healthy, he said that he threw up 3 or 4 times on the way, just altitude sickness, and you know, he just kicked his butt. He said it's the hardest thing he's ever done in his life. Was from this point to where we're going tomorrow.
Nah, I'm a bad motor scooter. What you doing, compass for 4 years in a row?
Michael was trying to run past the guides today. He said the guides were too slow.
The guides were going too slow. It was like, it's to the point to where I was having to balance on a foot. to wait for the next foot.
Good news is,
but we paid them to get us here.
Yeah.
And we paid them to tell us, slow down.
Yeah, the main thing is to get us here safely, to get us off the mountain safely. There's no injuries or health issues along the way. So,
yes, because I don't like to see.
You've had some bad winds in your life. Yeah. Do you think this is going to be the worst?
I do. I think physically, because of the breathing issue, because of the lack of oxygen, I think it will be the hardest thing I've ever done.
You agree?
No,
I'm serious.
Nah, for real.
Nah, he agrees.
Yeah.
Listen, I raised this boy. I know exactly what he's doing.
because you taught me how to do it.
Morning of summit. It's like negative 20. I'm not kidding.
Yeah, it's really cold.
It's the hardest part is
not a good gap.
No, yeah. The hardest part is catching your breath, as you can see. How many layers do you think you're going to have on? Backstory, his knees really hurt and he tore his ACL in a jiu-jitsu competition a long time ago and never got surgery. He just toughed it out. There, the summit. It's about 30 degrees colder up here. I think. Enough for me to put everything I had on. Right now we just took our medical test and my dad has like dangerously low oxygen, so thank God our guides are both medics and brought oxygen and some kind of pill, so they're getting him fixed up. Our destination is literally where we are, walk around here on that ridge line and then right there, but that's a little higher, so we gotta get him well before we continue.
oxygen was before the oxygen was 67 and the heart rate was 103, but soon after we gave him oxygen it went up to 90 over 100.
Nice.
So
good.
And you keep going.
There you go. So Andy's now needing oxygen. We're about,
we're so close,
20 minutes from summit, but like all the color's gone out of his lips, and they just tested his finger with the oxygen meter, and it's,
he's a 67.
Okay.
Or 66.
That's great.
And that's pretty dangerous.
And the level is 75.
Oh, I can't wait to get home over. Here's where we had to crash, and that's the summit. God save the king.
We're in the start of the forest jungle area. Only got about 2 or 3 hour walk to the gate and get picked up. And we got a 45 minute drive to the hotel.
Kilimanjaro, Kilimanjaro, Kilimanjaro.